HP says they're reinventing the PC with the Spectre Folio. Today I'm going to tell you if it's all hype or not. Stay tuned. All right, here we are, the Spectre Folio. Now, this is a laptop that's hard to describe. You can open it one-handed, so I'll do it that way. So they say there's no compromises on this device. It's basically perfect. And you gotta give them some credit. It really is a beautiful looking device. So we're talking a 4K panel display on here. It is touch. And as you can see here, it does have a pen with 4,096 levels of pressure plus tilt. So everything we got there, we got the webcam here at the top. And it does feature LTE, at least in one model. The other models also are available in Wi-Fi at Best Buy. You can get the LTE model direct though from HP. Coming down to the bottom here, you can see this keyboard deck. Familiar design from HP. You got the speakers on top as well as some, I assume, passive venting. It is a fanless design. It does run a Core i5 or i7 Y series processor, specifically the 8500Y. So it's a dual core chip. It's not the fastest out there, but supposedly it's going to get 18 hours of battery life out of this. We'll have to test it, but that is rated pretty high. The keyboard itself is a really nice familiar design, plenty of travel, backlit. Coming down to the bottom here, you got the nice leather as well as a trackpad. It is not precision, so if I had to knock one thing, it would be that, but it's still a very good trackpad. I don't have any complaints about it. Now, what makes this laptop so unique is going to be the ability for the screen to pop forward like this into a better consumptive mode. And so you can use it like this with the trackpad just to watch videos or do whatever you want or even draw on the screen. And then it can even go down and turn into a tablet. And I have to admit, it feels really nice in the hand to hold. It's not a very heavy device at all. In fact, it's one of the lightest ones out there. It just feels really cool, and you can switch between all those dynamic modes on the fly. When it comes to ports, there aren't a whole lot on this device that you would expect. There is a USB Type-C here, looks to be Thunderbolt 3, as well as a headphone jack here at the base. And coming around to the right-hand side, we have two more USB-C ports. Again, Thunderbolt and charging looks to be a pretty solid port option. Now regarding that LTE, it is Intel's first gigabit modem, so this should get very good speeds. And if you sign up with Sprint, you'll get 6 months of free data. We've seen that before with the always connected PCs from HP in the past, so pretty nice. You don't have to get an LTE though. In fact, the two entry level models don't have LTE on there, it's just Wi-Fi. But if you do want the LTE version, you can get it. And for those of you who don't like the cognac color, well, there's a second one available in burgundy, along with a luminous gold finish. It's a little bit more bright, so still pretty nice looking though. It's gonna be a tough one to choose. Okay, quick impressions here. So overall, I'm actually very impressed about this. It's hard to convey on video just how thin, light, and just really nice it feels in the hand. The leather really kind of changes it all up. And they really did some crazy innovation to make this all happen. So I'm pretty impressed with it. But what's even more impressive is the price. So it starts at $1,299. That's for the Core i5, 256, 8 gigabytes of RAM, and Wi-Fi. Now, if you want the Core i7, it goes to $1,399. And those will be available at Best Buy. If you want the big one, that's 256, 8, and a Core i7 plus LTE, well, you're only going to spend $1,499 on it, and that's with a 4K display. That's actually a really competitive price, so I'm overall very happy with it. Hopefully we'll get our hands on it and review it soon. But you tell me what you think. Leave me a comment below and let me know if you think HP reinvented the PC. Thanks for watching. Take care, everyone.